Thank you for stopping by Ballistic BBQ. On this video, I am going to be cooking up kind of a New Mexico inspired green chili cheeseburger. But get this, with the exception of the buns and a little butter I'll be putting on it, everything is going to be freeze dried and rehydrated. Let's get going. All right, so very recently I purchased a home freeze dryer. Again, I purchased this and I've been thinking about buying one for a while now, and a few reasons. The main reason is just where I live. We have fault lines running around, you know, this area. And I grew up out here in San Diego, been through some pretty crazy rides with the earthquakes, and just one of these days something's gonna happen. It's going to. We also have wildfires and everything. So I am a firm believer in food storage. I think everybody should be prepared. I don't want to be one of those people standing around a truck while they're throwing bags of rice at me. I want to be prepared for my family, for my friends. Another reason is backpacking. I do a lot of backpacking. And although some of those backpacking foods are decent, they still, especially after, you know, 7 days on the trail, they get that just that processed mass-produced flavor to where I'm choking it down more for sustenance than any type of enjoyment. And I love to eat, so that's an issue. Another reason is I want to be able to freeze dry ingredients that I can grind up and use in rubs. I'm really excited about that. And I have a very small family. It's just the three of us, so we have a lot of leftovers. My neighbors dig on it because I'm usually going across the street handing out, you know, tubs of brisket and pulled pork. But I want to start freeze drying some just to, you know, alleviate some of the room that we're taking up in the freezer. Freeze dried foods, you can store for up to 25 years if they're packaged correctly. So again, excited. Let's take a look at what I'm going to be freeze drying. So I have here four raw hamburger patties, and this is Angus beef. These were preformed patties, but they were fresh. They were not frozen. And this is 80/20 beef. Now, for the long-term storage, you want to keep the fat content down. So 80/20. Speaking with the folks over there at the company where I bought the freeze dryer from, Harvest Right, they're telling me that, you know, the higher fats, you can get a good 5 years of storage out of it. But again, you want the lean meats for the long-term storage. And while I've been playing with this machine, I actually freeze-dried and rehydrated a couple patties that were like 93% lean. And I'm pretty impressed, but for this video, I wanted to go with the fattier meat. Then I have here, this is grated, pretty heavily, you know, thick grade, sharp white cheddar cheese. Again, I've been messing around with this machine and I've discovered that the grated cheese rehydrates a lot better than the slices. Now, I came up with this idea literally this morning. These are onion rings from a local fast food joint, and I'm going to freeze dry these and leave them freeze dried as a crunch element on the cheeseburger that I'm making. Again, playing around with this machine, I found that some of the cooked freeze dried foods, just eating them freeze dried, it's really good. I have here Hatch green chilies, and these are canned, diced, and again, we're going to rehydrate this, and then I'm going to grill it up on the flat top. Another reason for freeze drying, we get fresh Hatch chilies, it's a mouthful, here in our local stores when they're in season. So I'm thinking, you know, buy up a bunch of them in bulk, freeze dry them, and I'll have my own, you know, supply of Hatch chilies, which are awesome. Anyway, you've seen what I'm going to be freeze drying. Now let's take a look at the freeze dryer. All right, and here is my home freeze dryer. Again, I bought this from a company called Harvest Right. This is their standard size, and they suggested, after talking to them, that I get this particular size because of the amount of food we have left over. They have three sizes, small, standard, which is medium, and large. Basically, this is about as big as a dorm refrigerator, like a beer refrigerator I have in my patio. Weighs about 100 pounds. And I have it on a utility cart just so I can wheel it around for my videos. Most of the use will take place, personal use, will be in the garage. And I just think, you know, this is a better backdrop than my garage. Behind here on the cart, I have a vacuum pump. So basically what happens is I turn it on and it starts the refrigeration process, the freezing process, takes it down to 30 degrees below zero. And this is, it's either 8 or 9 hours, I'll tell you as soon as I turn it on, process. Once it hits that, again, that 8 or 9 hour mark, the vacuum pump kicks on and it creates a total vacuum inside here. And it actually takes it down to even colder than 30 degrees below zero Fahrenheit once the vacuum takes place. The whole freeze-dry process usually takes about 20 hours. I've done, so far, 3 batches of food experimenting, and so far I'm very, very pleased with this. Yesterday I rehydrated a big pasta dish that I had a lot of leftovers from an Italian restaurant. Rehydrated it for lunch, just added hot water, and I was shocked. It tasted like it just came out of the kitchen at the restaurant. And I was sitting there imagining, wow, this up in the Sierras at 12,000 feet would be a treat. Anyway, so let's check this out. It's got a really thick, like plexiglass door here. Open it up, and there's a cylinder and like a rectangular shaped cube in here with shelves. And each one of these shelves is heated. So when it's going to the drying process, the heaters actually turn on, but again, it's under a deep freeze. So it's magic way beyond my comprehension. Let's go ahead and get this process going. So these shelves, the shelves I have the food on, actually came with the machine. And I put parchment paper on here just to help with the cleanup, even though from what I've seen, because everything's so dry when it comes out, cleanup is pretty minimal. So I'll put this up here. Now it comes with this like a padded door seal, just makes a better seal in the door here. And this goes right in the opening. Now we are ready to turn it on. And while I'm thinking about it, when I test drove this recipe before I decided to make a video on it. And I thought it'd be cool to freeze dry and rehydrate the buns. And the way I did it was I test drove basically 2 buns, a potato bun, which is very soft, and then a pretzel bun, obviously very dense and firm. And then my thought was to rehydrate it over a pot with steam, boiling water basically. And I put a grate over there and steamed them. I got it to where it was soft as a fresh bun, but then after pulling it off the steam, minutes later, it was again hard as a rock. So if there are any experienced freeze dryers out there that have rehydrated bread or buns and know or can tell me how to do it, I'd definitely appreciate your help. So let's get this going. So the machine is plugged in, it's turned on. And as you can see, there's an LCD touch screen here. Basically tells you to start, so let's start. Now it's going to remind you to close the drain valve. I'll explain why. Once you're done with the freeze drying, you'll have an opportunity to increase the time if there's still more moisture in the food that needs to be dried out. If you're satisfied, you'll pull the food out and then you'll go into a defrost mode. And basically, all the moisture that comes out of the food freezes inside of the walls of that cylinder that you saw inside there. As it defrosts, obviously it turns into water, melts, and it goes down to a drain. And I have the hose going through the bottom of the cart into a bucket. So, valve is closed. We are ready to turn this thing on. And so, it's 9 hours. This process will take 9 hours. So again, after 9 hours, it'll kick on the drying, the freeze drying process. And 20 hours from now, we're going to have freeze-dried hamburgers. I will see you tomorrow. I will rehydrate all this stuff and cook it for you. See you in a bit. All right, here we are. It's been about 20 hours and we are done. And I'm very, very happy with the results. I've always been kind of amazed. I mean, ever since I was a little kid with freeze-dried food, to think I'm doing it at my house now is just wild. So here we go. Hamburger patties. I mean, it looks like raw meat when you look at it, but it's got the texture of like a wafer, a biscuit, like a very dry wafer. Crazy. The cheese, again, dry as a bone, just crumbles. The onion rings. Now, again, I'm using this as a crunch element in the burger. I'm not going to rehydrate these. So check that out. And let me give this a try. I mean, it breaks like a dry pretzel. Wow. Really good. Really good. And the peppers, again, it's almost like very brittle styrofoam. Pretty cool. So next thing will be rehydrating what I'm going to use for this recipe, preserving what I'm going to store. Two ways they suggest. One way is to put it in mason jars with an oxygen absorber. The second way, which is the way that I'm going to do, is a Mylar bag with an oxygen absorber in here. That's a mouthful for me, oxygen absorber, O2 absorber. The reason I'm going with this is, for me, it's very light. I don't have to worry about breaking it. It protects the food in here from, you know, UV rays. And I can grab it, toss it in a backpack, and I'm good to go. So going with the Mylar bags. I'll have a link down below for Harvest Right. You can check out everything they have, but basically what I got from them is it's like a heat bar that simply welds the Mylar bag together. And then I just, you know, before I do that, I toss the absorber in there and it's good to go. So let me get the stuff that I'm not going to use out of the way, and then we'll start the rehydration process. All right, we are ready to start rehydrating some freeze-dried food. And I wanted to show you something that I found. Actually, I found this book. It's Rehydration Calculations Made Easy. And it was suggested in a forum I was looking at on freeze drying. It's in US measurements as well as metric system. And it's just really straightforward. You just sort of look up what you have freeze dried and it tells you how much water to use to rehydrate it. So it's pretty cool. So I have here the cheese. It's 1 cup of cheese and I'm adding 2 cups of fresh water. And our water here isn't the best of municipal water, so I'm using, you know, good bottled water. So we'll set that aside. Now the hamburger patty. The cool thing about meats like this, just add water. It'll take up as much as it needs, and what it doesn't use, you drain off. In fact, what the cheese doesn't use, we're just going to drain off. But this is pretty cool though. I did those first hamburger patties just the other day, and to watch it go from this wafer into actual meat, it was just amazing to me. And again, I cooked it up and it was just like a regular hamburger. So I'll set this aside. Now those hatch chilies. I'm actually going to be kind of cooking these down after they rehydrate. Again, I'm kind of doing that New Mexico thing here. So I'm just going to add some water because, again, what water isn't used will get cooked down anyway. And I suspect that these are going to rehydrate very quickly. So I'm just going to cover them with water. If it needs more, I'll add more. I tried out some of these freeze-dried. Really good. Again, it had that kind of vinegary taste, I guess, because of what they're preserved in. The cheese was also very good freeze-dried without being rehydrated. And now for this bad boy, the extra burger patty. I have something special that I'm going to do with this. And again, as I was watching the videos on freeze drying, I found a lot of the videos helpful, but I guess my plan is to kind of step outside the box. I want to do some videos of, I'm going to answer some questions that I wanted answered that weren't available on the videos. But again, I'm going to kind of push the threshold of freeze drying a little bit. I want to show you what I'm going to do here. So I concocted what you were about to see this morning, and hopefully it'll work. But I started thinking about how a lot of the restaurants, or some of the restaurants in New Mexico, prepare their green chili cheeseburgers, again in Hatch, New Mexico. And some of them put, as they're cooking down the chilies in water, they'll add ground beef to it. So I thought, let's grind some beef, and I'm going to grind freeze-dried beef into a powder. Hopefully, we'll see if this works. Wow. Get this out of the way. There we go. Well, it's powder. So as I'm bringing the chilies up to a boil in the water, I'm going to add this, some of the beef patty grind, to just sort of add some beefy flavor to the chilies, along with probably a little salt. So I'm going to let the cheese and the meat and the chilies continue to rehydrate. See you guys in a bit. All right, so it hasn't been very long at all. The chilies are already rehydrated and the meat's rehydrated. I have it on a paper plate right now in the fridge. We're still waiting on the cheese. It's coming along, but you know, it's, I guess, denser. It's not as porous as these other items. So it's taking a little while. So again, the chili's in here and I have some water. Let's get it on some heat. So now what I'm going to do is add a couple tablespoons of that powdered hamburger meat, stir that in. The meat just came alive when I put it in there. I mean, it looks like little bits of hamburger now. It doesn't need a whole lot of seasoning. I tasted it just before I turned the cameras on, but I'm going to add just a pinch of smoked sea salt. Just add a little bit of smoky flavor. A little bit more salty. So really all I'm going to do now is bring this up to a boil and I'm going to simmer out most of the water. When we're outside cooking on the grill, I'm going to take the portion that I will be topping the cheeseburger with and kind of finishing off on the flat top, give it a little bit of caramelization. So I'm going to let this do its thing. I will see you outside at the Weber, where we are going to cook up this freeze-dried New Mexico-style green chili cheeseburger with the addition of freeze-dried onion rings, which are killer, by the way. I mean, really, really good. We'll see you outside. All right, everything is rehydrated, brought back to life. I have a new snack called freeze-dried onion rings. The stewed Hatch chilies with a little bit of salt and that powdered hamburger taste amazing. So very happy with that. Let's start cooking. A little bit of cooking oil down on the ballistic griddle. Take that freeze-dried patty, little kosher salt, and on the flat top it goes. Some more kosher salt. There's going to be plenty of spice with those chilies going on, so I'm not going to worry about that. So I'm using butter buns. I'm going to spread a little butter on the butter buns. Just toast it on the indirect side here. Take some of that chili, put it right down. Burger's coming along, let's give it a flip. Got that cheese on there. Now in New Mexico, the chili would go on first and the cheese. Again, this is inspired New Mexico. Some water. All right, look at that. Melted, freeze-dried, rehydrated cheese. Let's build a burger. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is lay down this amazing, crisp, freeze-dried onion rings. I mean, these are probably gonna be my favorite part of this hamburger. Now again, New Mexico, don't hate me, this is inspired. I've already done a New Mexico-style green chili cheeseburger, so I just wanted to kind of build on those flavors that you guys have, which I love. On top of these onion rings. So I've got a nice protective bed now of the freeze-dried onion rings. I'm going to put those kind of caramelized, charred, stewed chilies with that beefy flavor. They smell amazing. And then on top of that, this burger, that melted white cheddar, and of course, crown it with that butter bun. Looks good. Again, guys, this was freeze-dried with the exception of the bun and the butter. Everything here was freeze-dried and resurrected. And I'm excited. I've been nibbling away at some of the elements of this burger in the kitchen as I was kind of prepping the grill. So I'm excited. Let's give this a try here. Ah, I mean, it's dripping juice. You'd never know. You'd never know. You could come over, I could give you this hamburger off the grill. You'd never know that this had been freeze-dried. It's crazy. Still some decent color. I'll try to give you a shot of this bun or the patty. It's not as gray as I was expecting, you know, having been taken down to like 30 below zero or whatever. The cheese, still very, very creamy, melted. It's got that nice, this is a sharp white cheddar, that nice bite. Wow. I'm almost done with this thing. I'm really excited. You have no idea. If you had held this hamburger patty, and again, it was light as a feather, it felt like a wafer cookie, and now it's a hamburger and I'm eating it. It's crazy. The cheese, again, nice, warm, gooey, melted cheddar cheese. This is exciting for me. I'm having fun with this freeze dryer. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video because I'd like to do more. I mean, it's definitely deviating from what I do normally, but it's what I'm doing. So why not share it with you guys? And again, I think it has a place in the outdoor cooking realm, especially when it comes to preserving leftovers. If you have any ideas, please let me know. My idea box is running full speed right now, and I'm thinking like freeze-dried spare ribs, freeze-dried beef ribs. I want to do a steak. The ideas are endless, and I want to see what I can pull off, what fails, what doesn't. So, again, any ideas, please help me out here. On tap today, we have one of my favorites. You've seen me drink this a zillion times, Modelo Negro. It's a Mexican beer. It's a lager, but it's got that kind of a medium body, and it's just got a really nice, rich flavor, and it goes so well with, you know, well, this is kind of a Southwest thing going on, but like Mexican food. So, thanks for stopping by. Again, keep those suggestions rolling. See you on the next video. Cheers.